எல்லாம் நிறைந்திருக்கிறது இங்கே. யூ நீ நாட் கோ எனிவேர், ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டே. ஸோ ஐ ஜஸ்ட் ரீட் ஒன்லி த தமிழ் ஆஃப் தம். இலைகளின் பல பல நிறங்கள், கண்களுக்கோ வர்ணங்களின் விருந்து. நிறத்தில் இந்த மரண நடனம் கிளர்ச்சியானது அல்ல, கடும் குளர்ச்சியால் ஆனது. மகுடமும் ஆடையும் யாவும் சரிந்து விழுந்து வாழ்வூட்டும் ஜீவசக்தியை இழந்து இலை பூ பழமற்று மரங்கள் வெறுமையாய் நிற்கும் மீண்டும் உயிர் தழுவதை எதிர்பார்த்து. இலையுதிர் காலத்தின் வீழ்ச்சி, குளிர்காலத்தின் அழுகல், வசந்த காலத்தின் வியப்பு. இது வாழ்வா சாவதா என்பது பற்றியல்ல, வாழ்வும் சாவும் பற்றியது. பேரழிவல்ல இது, ஒரு பெரும் திருவிழா. செல்ல வேறிடமில்லை, எல்லாம் நிறைந்திருக்கிறது இங்கே. ஸோ ப்ளீஸ், வி ஹாவ் டு என்ஜாய் திஸ் பர்டிகுலர் மொமெண்ட் ஆஃப் ஆட்டம், ஜஸ்ட் டு ஹாவ் அ ரீபர்த், ஈவன் தோ வி ஆர் ஷெட்டிங் ஆல் அவர் இன்ஹிபிஷன்ஸ். பி வித் அஸ், திஸ் இஸ் த கிரேட் ஃபிலாசபி ஆஃப் லைஃப்.
Kavita Karve Vaidya. You couldn't have a better name, madam.
This poem is a note about it. It's at its best for the loving couples, and it's also at the best of the nature. So everything is at the best. How it can turn duality into non-duality is something which I'm trying to portray through this poem, which has the ras of Radha and Krishna as a part of it. Name of the poem is Sharadaranga. I have written this poem myself. Sharadacha Chandanyata अनस्वल्प गारव्यात, शरदाचा चांदण्यात अनस्वल्प गारव्यात, रजनी नाथा समेत लख लखत्या चांदण्यात, रजनी नाथा समेत लख लखत्या चांदण्यात. ऋतुमोहन चंद्रभान सौम्यशी नखरेल रात. दिस इज अबाउट द ऑटम. ऋतुमोहन चंद्रभान सौम्यशी नखरेल रात, तुझ सम निळाईशांत, तुझ सम निळाईशांत अन कृष्णा अंबरात, तुझ सम निळाईशांत अन कृष्णा अंबरात, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात. दरवळ रातराणीचा, रात्र आली की रात्राणी आलीच पाहिजे. दरवळ रातराणीचा मंद गंध समीरात, दरवळ रातराणीचा मंद गंध समीरात, राजस ऋतुरंग स्पर्श अश्विन पुनवेची साथ. शरद पौर्णिमा इज सपोज टू बी व्हेरी ब्युटिफुल. राजस ऋतुरंग स्पर्श अश्विन पुनवेची साथ, जवळी सखी राधिका, जवळी सखी राधिका स्पंदनेही अंतरात, जवळी सखी राधिका स्पंदनेही अंतरात, कृष्णमयी कृष्णलीन रजतरात रजत साथ, कृष्णमयी कृष्णलीन रजतरात रजत साथ, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात. बासरीचा सूरमंद, बासरीचा सूरमंद ओघळतो जणू जळात, बासरीचा सूरमंद ओघळतो जणू जळात, मोर पीस माथ्यावरी ओठांवरी सुस्मित, मोर पीस माथ्यावरी ओठांवर सुस्मित, वृंदावनी रचिला सरास, वृंदावनी रचिला सरास सर्व गोपिकांसमेत, वृंदावनी रचिला सरास सर्व गोपिकांसमेत, कृष्ण राधा विश्वरूप द्वैत झाले अद्वैत, कृष्ण राधा विश्वरूप द्वैत झाले अद्वैत, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात, शरदाच्या चांदण्यात, रजनीनाथा समेत लखलखत्या चांदण्यात, शरदाचा चांदण्यात अनस्वल्प गारव्यात रजनी नाथा समेत लखलखत्या चांदण्यात. Splendid cloudless full moon night in Sharad Rutu is an idiom of glory, peace and joy in the Indian poetics. It is the delight of eager young loves that long to be with their beloved. Its glory, tenderness and joy are celebrated in songs, legends and poems of love. This is also a season of festivity. You will see Navratri falls into this festival this time. So it's basically Sharad Rutu, which is followed by Varsha Rutu. So it's a season of festivals and marked by benevolence and grace and beauty of the season. So this is probably this probably attracts the people, young people or couples. And Vrindavan, wherever the Ras is there, it is supposed to be a festivity. Navratri is the major season when they play Ras, which is also again, which is identifying with Shakti, you know. So Radha is a Shakti, Krishna and Radha, their Advaita becomes, the whole world becomes Krishnamaya, and that is what actually made me write these lines about Krishna and Radha, because autumn is very, very closely associated to that. That's what I feel personally. And Anta Bhav, which is there, which has come because of the union of all the bhavas together, and which we all know that Shantaras is created by the mixture of all the rasas. So that's what I felt when I wrote it there. Thank you so much.
You're right, because I think there's Vasanta Navratri and there is the Sharad Navratri. There are two Navratri moon, and what better moon than the Sharad moon? Okay, great. So we now move to Dr. Dilip Jhaveri, who will be talking to us about Gujarati poetry, and he's an acclaimed...
Hindu, you talk about it. Tushan, Ahara Dhavala, Ya Shubha Vastavata, Ya Veenavara Danda Manditakara, Ya Shweta Padmasa, Sanah Patu Saraswati Bhagavati, Nishesha Chajapa. The name of Saraswati is Sharada. That comes from Sharad. And the richness is so simple. Kunja, Hindu, Tushar. Poetry has only this richness. And then you find Brahma, Achyut, Shankara. They all worship her because she has no desire of anything beyond this beauty. So these are the elements of Sharad Rutu. Kund, Indu, Tushar. In Bengali, Rabindranath wrote a very simple poem, and then afterwards I read it rapidly. आलोर अमल कमल खानी के फुटाले नील आकाशेर घूम उड़ाले आमार मोनेर भावना गुली बाहिर होलो पाखा तुली ओई कमलेर पथे तादेर शेई डुटाले आलोर कमल अमल कमल खानी शरद बानीर बिना बाजे कमल दोले सी दिस साउंड शरत वानीर वीणा वाजे कमल तले ललित रागे सुरे जरे शिवलि तले ताई तो बाताष मेड़ाय मेते कची धानेर सबूज खेते बनेर प्राणे मरमरानीर ढेउ उड़ाले शरत वानीर वीणा वाजे कमल तले. Now this is how the Bengali goes. I will not try to explain, just the music of the language. वीणा वरदंड मंडित करा. Hear the music of Veena there. Our greatest poet, Rajendra Shah, we are observing his centenary very recently, and he was the greatest lyrical poet. And two lyrics, Pili Che Pangani, Pili, પીળી છે પાંદડીને કાળવો છું બાજરો, સોય છે જાજરો સવારથી એ જાજરો, પીળી છે પાંદડી ને કાળવો છે બાજરો. યલો ઇઝ ધ લીફલેટ એન્ડ ડાર્ક બ્લેક ઇઝ ધ મિલેટ. It looks beautiful, more beautiful in the evening than the morning. ઝાકળીએ બેસું ને તોય તે બપોર લાગે આસોદા માસના અકારા. ઝાકળીએ બેસું, I sit in the shade in the farm. ઝાકળીએ બેસું ને તોય તે બપોર લાગે આસોતે માસના અકારા. આવડા અધિકડાના વિત્યા વૈશાખના આંબાની ડાળ ઝૂલનારા. The afternoon heat of Ashwin Mas is unbearable even when I'm sitting in the shed in the field. The heat of Vaishak May also was not that unbearable. Ambani dal chindara hu to anjwali raat no manu jaguro pidi che bandadi nikalo. The night is bright. This is the only season where you find the brightest of the nights. Indu Jyotsna. Aambli ni chhaye te kadamb ni jhana. Mara mannu to paan ke nikle. Kosna te paani na dhariya nu vel mane lage kalindari jeevo. You're talking of Krishna. The water flowing from the well, I feel as if it is the water of Kalidi. Aambli ni chhai, the shadow of tamarind, te kadamb ni janai, it looks like kadamb. Mara mannu tofaan kone ke, main to deetho, radhani sang khelan to saavaro. મેં તો બીઠો રાધાની સંગ ખેલન તો સાવરો પીળી છે પાંદડી નિકાળવો છે બાજુ. યુ સી ફ્રોમ એલિમેન્ટ્સ ઇન સંસ્કૃત ટુ ધ જેનેરિક્સ વિચ રવિન્દ્રનાથ ડિસ્ક્રાઇબ રાજેન્દ્ર શાહ બ્રિંગ્સ ધેટ ટુ સ્પેસિફિક્સ ધી એક્સપિરિયન્સ ઓફ અ સીઝન બાય ફાર્મિંગ કોમ્યુનિટી એન્ડ ઈચ એન્ડ એવરીથિંગ. કુંજ કુંજ રણકંતી કુંજ કુંજ રણકંતી સાઉન્ડ સાઉન્ડ સાઉન્ડ. રોમ રોમ માહી નહીં માતો આનંદ, રોમ રોમ માહી નહીં માતો આનંદ, એમ જાજેરું ઝૂકતું રોમ. એસે આસમાન જો હૈ રોમ રોમ મેં આનંદ નહીં સમા રહા હૈ, એસે આસમાન ઝુક રહા હૈ. વર્ષે છે આજ ભલી વાસ તારી જાતર, વર્ષે છે આજ ભલી વાસ તારી જાતર, આસો લીલા એવી હવા છે કોઈ એવી છે લહેર, મન મૂંગાને બોલવું અપાર. એસી હવા ચલ રહી એસી લહેર હૈ કે જો ખામોશ જો મેરા દિલ હૈ ઉસકો અપાર બેહદ બોલના હૈ.
આઈ હોપ આઈ કેન ડૂ જસ્ટિસ ટુ ધીસ. One of the pleasures for me being here today is to see that, you know, the celebration of nature and how poets across languages and geographies can, you know, cut through and share the same emotion. And for me, that is a very important aspect of this evening. Now, we're talking about literature in English. One of the, you know, over autumn, one of the first poems that comes to mind is one that I'm not going to read today because you will hear the next speaker after me, Ode to Autumn. But there are several other poets who have been writing about autumn in different languages and English translation. They are available in English translation. And I was reading this, Rilke says this, you know, he says, he's talking about autumn, and he says, at no other time than autumn does the earth let itself be inhaled in one smell, the ripe earth, in a smell that is in no way inferior to the smell of the sea, bitter where it borders on taste, and more honey sweet where you feel it touching the first sounds, containing death within itself, darkness, something of the grave almost. Of course, though poetry about autumn can be very melancholy, there are also several poets who speak about, you know, the celebration, the joy, the splendor of the season. And in fact, Rilke himself has a poem called Autumn, which I'll read to you. The leaves are falling, falling as if from far up, as if orchards were dying high in space. Each leaf falls as if it were motioning, no. And tonight, the heavy earth is falling away from all other stars in the loneliness. We're all falling. This hand here is falling. And look at the other one. It's in them all. And yet, there is someone whose hands, infinitely calm, holding up all this falling.
Mukarrar Irshad. Mukarrar Irshad is dubara.
Can I read other poems? Should I read again? Okay. Okay, so that's my 5 minutes up then, right? Autumn by Rainer Maria Rilke. The leaves are falling, falling as if from far up, as if orchards were dying high in space. Each leaf falls as if it were motioning, no. And tonight the heavy earth is falling away from all other stars in the loneliness. We are all falling. This hand here is falling. And look at the other one. It's in them all. And yet there is someone whose hands, infinitely calm, holding up all this falling. All. There is one by Emily Dickinson, one of my favorite poets. Let me just find it here without a guess. These are the days when birds come back. These are the days when birds come back, a very few, a bird or two, to take a backward look. These are the days when skies put on the old, old sophistries of June, a blue and gold mistake. Oh, fraud that cannot cheat the bee, almost thy plausibility induces my belief. To ranks of seeds their witness bear, and softly through the altered air hurries a timid leaf. Oh, sacrament of summer days, O last communion in the haze, permit a child to join thy sacred emblems to partake, thy consecrated bread to break, taste thine immortal wine. Further in summer than the birds, pathetic from the grass, a minor nation celebrates its unobtrusive mass. No ordinance is seen, so gradual the grace, a pensive custom it becomes, enlarging loneliness. Antiquest felt at noon, when August, burning low, calls forth the spectral canticle, repose to typify. Remit as yet no grace, no furrow on the glow, yet a druidic difference enhances nature now. Okay, I'm going to read two contemporary poems. If there's time later, maybe.
Okay, last.
This is for Gujarati.
Chalo.
Oh!
ये हाथ सामने से हाथ हटाओ ना, ये वाला लेफ्ट हैंड हटाओ ना, फेस तो दिखने दो। तबले पे लाइट दो, तबले पे लाइट दो, हाँ वेरी गुड। थोड़ा पीछे से लाइट, लाइट थोड़ा पीछे से दो। ओके
मंश,
हाँ चलो
गुजराती।
Thank you very much guys. Namaskar.